Good day, Sagittarius, and welcome to my channel. I'm Misha, the Psychotic Psychedelic Gypsy, and this is your weekly reading for June 26th to July 2nd. If you're new here, welcome. If you're coming back, welcome back. I hope you're all doing well, and I hope this reading resonates with you. Also, if you watch my videos and you like my videos, but you're not subscribed, please subscribe. It helps my channel so much. And the analyticals on my channel have shown me that most people that watch my videos constantly are not subscribed. Sorry, it's kind of early. All right, let's see what we have for you this week. Universe speak. Spirits guide. What needs to be known? What lessons need to be learned? Ten of Diamonds. Four of Spades. Two of Clubs. And the Six of Diamonds. Okay, well, it looks like there's going to be a lot of confusion and misled feelings this week. But the cards say that you need to recheck your steps throughout the whole week, because this confused, misled feeling that you're getting, it's false. Most likely your own mind is coming up with it, or somebody has made you think that you're confused or misled. You might even watch something that made you confused and misled, and you need to really, like, just retrace your steps, because it's false. It's not real, and it looks like you're going to be going through this throughout the whole week. You're going to be feeling confused and misled, but you're not. You probably most likely know either the truth, or you know what you need to do. Like, you're not really confused. You're not. No one's misled you. You just feel that way. You know what you need to do and whatnot. You know what I'm saying? So just recheck your steps, and you'll realize that you're not confused or misled. At the beginning of the week, you have a chance to make it rain. Big success is coming to you, provided that you leave your comfort zone. It's going to be unpleasant, because that's how it is when we leave our comfort zone. And no, I don't care if you like your comfort zone. Somebody posted, "I like my comfort zone." It's like, well, here's the thing. We all like our comfort zones, okay? That's like why it's called the comfort zone. And but the thing is that if you want something new in your life, or you want some kind of success, most of the time you have to leave your comfort zone to get that success. You have to go through unpleasant things. So yeah, at the beginning of the week, if something unpleasant comes up that, you know, you necessarily wouldn't do, or you don't really want to do, or whatever, you might want to do it, because it's going to help you make it rain. It's going to bring you much abundance. In the middle of the week, it looks like you're going to have some loneliness, possibly some depression. You might even have some disappointment in your partner. But either way, you need to look into a good friend, like a real friend, somebody that when you tell them the truth, they tell you the truth. They don't hold back. They let you know what the truth really is. And that's what you need right now, is a really good friend. And then you need music. Lots and lots of music. Either the words will soothe you and give you ideas of how not to be lonely or sad or, you know, depressed. Or, you know, just play music that you can dance to and try to enjoy yourself, you know, as best as you can. This is my cat. Don't know if you Sagittarius have met her yet. This is Poison. She likes to come on the table and mess everything up. Anyway, so yeah, look in the music. Positive music. Not anything, you know, down, which, you know, most of us know. Which most of us, when we're down or depressed or something, that's kind of what we do. It's kind of a, you know, misguided thing to do, is to listen to sadder music when you're sad. So definitely listen to some positive music, and get yourself out of that lonely, sad feeling. And Kitty, I would really like to see what the other card is. Can you get come here? Oh my God, come here. Oh, okay. So it looks like you're going to be waiting on something. There's going to be a delay either in business or in love. I'm going to say this is probably business. Perhaps it's just making it rain, you know. Or you could be waiting. It could be both. It could be both, business and love. You could be waiting for this, whatever you did out of your comfort zone, to this success to happen, you know, this abundance. You might be waiting for that to happen. Perhaps it hasn't paid out yet or whatever, but give it time, you know. Or you might be waiting for your partner to, you know, get you past this disappointment that they've caused. And all you can do for either one of them, Jesus, look how much you messed this up. All you can do is plan and prepare. Plan and prepare for the best outcomes, plan and prepare for the worst outcomes. And plan and prepare for the middle outcomes. But don't sit there and dread upon the bad outcomes, okay? Instead, think about the good outcomes, expect the bad outcomes, but also know what you're going to do if the bad outcome comes. That makes sense? I think that makes sense. Anyway, so let's take a look and see what the tarot cards have to say. Universe speak. Spirits guide. What needs to be known? What lessons need to be learned? Temperance. Yeah, it's time for you to take a positive and turn it into a or take a negative and turn it into a positive. Wow, I was saying that really backwards. Take a negative and turn it into a positive is what you need to do right now. And you have the ability to do it. So, like here with the loneliness and the depression, that would be a negative, and you need to turn it into a positive. Well, honestly, so I think this is actually probably about love and business, this delay. You might have two delays going on this week. But, you know, the comfort zone, leaving the comfort zone, that's a negative, but it can turn into a positive. Loneliness is a negative, but you can turn it into a positive with a good friend and music. So yeah, this is a time for you to start turning negatives into positives. You have the knowledge, as you know, the ring around her head proves that she knows, she has the knowledge, and she can make things grow. And yeah, so right now you need to change negatives into positives. Work opposite to emotion. You know, don't let this loneliness or this unpleasantness get in the way of the things that you want out of life. I hope this resonated. If it did, hit that like button. And if you would, please comment, share, and subscribe. I hope to see you back here next week. And until then, stay safe, stay mindful, and stay healthy.